We're going to take another look at the 2024 recruiting class, and we're going to shine a spotlight on four-star linebacker Elijah Newby, who signed with the USC Trojans. We're going to look at his highlights. We're going to look at his 24/7 Sports player profile page. Before we do all that, you need to click that subscribe button right now, because we're talking about the 2024 and 2025 recruiting class every single day this offseason, and you need to know what your players look like before they hit the field. Click that button. Stop missing out. Here's his 24/7 Sports player profile page. If you're here for just the highlights, fast forward a few minutes, you'll get there. He's ranked as the 21st best linebacker in the class, however, ranked 12th in the composite. Four-star prospect with both sets of rankings, 6'3", 210. So we got some size, we also got some length here. We're enrolled with USC. We had 27 offers. That's a fair amount of offers. That means college football liked them. They wanted them on their team. We saw a lot of Power 5 schools try to get after him. We don't have a scouting report, but one thing sticks out like a sore thumb. He runs in the 10s in the 100 meter, 10.9, 10.94, 10.96, and that's with him being 6'3", 210. So he's cooking. He's got good size adjusted athleticism. I can't wait to see what he does on the field here. Again, Stanford, South Carolina, USC, we're a Trojan. Going over to On3, he's a four-star with everybody else. On3 has him ranked 5th among linebackers. ESPN has him at 15. Rivals has him at 17. 24/7 Sports is a little bit low here. 6'3", 205 is what they got him listed at. USC, Penn State, Boston College, Villanova, Nebraska. So Power 5 schools are looking at him. But we're going to take a look at the highlights. We're going to see what he's cooking with. 8 minutes, 39 seconds. Let me know what you think in the comments below. Let me know if you see anything. This is my live reaction. I'm seeing some sweet feet. I saw a little pop off the step there with the burst. Definitely see a kick there at the end. Did not get to see top end speed. Did not have enough time there for him to get into it. Oh, he put that guy on his back. Out of frame here. Here we go. Now we're in for. He's quick. He's quick. He's got the goods athletically. He's got ball skills there. Did he catch that? Did he just have it in his hands? What happened there? What happened there? What happened? Was that a trick play? Was that a trick play? On the outside here, coming in. He's fast. You got a 10-9 guy blitzing off the edge. Who's got some power. This is a prospect that's going to wreak havoc if he develops. There's so much potential here. I can definitely see that. That screams off the first few plays. Coming up the gut. There he is. There he is. This is dark here. They're playing with no lights, basically. He's got speed to burn. He's a guy. He's got his frame set up to where he can play anywhere. Look at that. Look at that closing speed. He's got a good release. Good setup there. Ball skills. You can play on either side of the ball if you wanted to. Like that size and just athleticism, you can play on either side of the ball. He runs in the tens at 200 some pounds. He's too quick. He's too quick to be ranked in the 200s overall. Not just 200s, like the 250 range. My goodness. He's downfield making plays. Trojan fans, you gotta let me know what you think about this guy. Let me know what's up with him. Why is he ranked so low? Because I don't see why. I'm not understanding it. I can make a case Like, maybe they saw something in a camp or practice or something, or heard something from a coach. But in this range of rankings, we're seeing that too often. On3's got him listed higher. I feel like that's more... He's dominant. You can make a case maybe for level of competition. Maybe. But how many linebackers are you seeing with this speed? How many guys do you see coming off the edge with this? He's just going to chase him down. Look at that. There's just difference there. There's just a difference. He's all over the place. Collapses the play. He's got quicks. He's got quicks for days. He can play either side of the ball. He hits good. He hits good. Look at that. Navigating through trash. Getting to the play. I'll say he's on the edge a lot, so really depends on where you're going to want to put him, but he's holding containment good. Seems to have a good feel of what's around him. Look at him blitz from back there. So quick, you can disguise that. Gets off the block. Like, the offensive linemen on the other teams aren't too shabby. Like, we've seen guys ranked a lot higher going up against offensive linemen or other side of the ball against defensive linemen. That you're like, whoa, that's a middle schooler. His feet are sweet, though. Are you guys sure you don't want him on offense? Are you guys sure about that? I think he's good coming off the edge. I think he's great at that. I think he's got good speed. I think he's got some power. I think he's got a good feel of getting to the ball. He's very assertive. And then when you see him on offense, you're like, wow. That size just athleticism. Sets him apart. Catch the ball behind him. He's got a decent release package. On the outside here. Hold and contain while coming in. They try to sneak one by him. That was designed to sneak by him. And they're like, ugh, didn't work. Stayed home. My guess is there's probably some aspects to his game where there needs development. And that's what 24/7 Sports is doing. I look at it glass half full, though, and I see that size adjusted athleticism, and I see the recovery times here, closing the gap. And I compare that with a lot of the linebackers we've covered here recently. And I'd rather have him, to be frank. We've covered the running backs ranked ahead of him on 24/7 Sports. I'd rather have him than last 5 to 10 guys we've covered at linebacker, for sure. Because of the speed and the burst, the upside, the potential to move him anywhere, just anywhere. Like, I'd rather have that. So quick. Like, he's dynamic. Like, he can make an impact anywhere on the field. Like, say I get a good transfer portal class at linebacker and I got to make a move somewhere else, or I got a whole wide receiver, tight end, or somewhere. I got him. I can move him. I know I can do that. He's got a lot of versatility. The fact that his feet are so smooth is something different, too. For his height, he's 6'3". And he's got feet that are smooth compared to like a 5'11" guy. And he moves quick. Typically, the taller you get, the less smooth you are on the feet because of physics. It's just harder to do. Doesn't mean you can't or it's impossible for a taller guy. It's just you don't see it as often. Look at that. He's very assertive, too. Quick decisions. This is a guy that I'm highly intrigued by. I think he's got a lot of upside. He's highly versatile. I think he's going to be doing good things for USC one way or another. I like him. If he just puts the pedal to the metal on his development, you got yourself a big-time player who's playing on Sundays. And linebacker coming off that edge, that pass rush, the recoverability skills, the ability to put him on offense too if you wanted to. You got a mold of clay here that can do almost anything you want. And he's a guy that can play almost any position because of that speed. He's faster than a lot of cornerbacks. He's faster than a lot of wide receivers. He's probably one of the fastest linebackers in college football. Think of it in that realm. He's probably one of the fastest linebackers in college football right now at this instant. Because there's not many linebackers who cook with this speed, especially at this size. At linebacker, he will add some speed. Will it make him slower? Probably not. It'll probably still be good. With his size added, with some more mass, that it'll still be good. If anything, he could get quicker. That's one thing, because it'll get stronger with more pop off the step, especially working on the squats, working on the burst and all that stuff. That being said, this guy has tremendous upside. Tremendous upside. 24/7 Sports, way too low on him. Let me know what you think in the comments below. Make sure to hit that subscribe button on the way out. One thing for watching. Catch you on the next video.